He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Being the physics enthusiast that you are, you decide to construct a little pulley system at home from some materials you found lying around. The finished product consists of a string connecting two blocks via a frictionless pulley. 3.5 kilogram block A rests on a ramp, while 1.3 kilogram block B hangs straight down from the pulley. The ramp is at an angle of 50 degrees off the horizontal, and it is frictionless. If you hold the two blocks in place and then suddenly let go, what will happen? Will block A move downwards? Will block B move downwards? Or will everything stay where it is? To answer this, we need to use Newton's laws, tension, and some trigonometry. So if this seems overwhelming, check out my tutorials on these subjects first. Once you are good to go, give this a shot. To figure out what's going to happen, let's identify all the forces acting on each object. For the block that is hanging, there is simply the gravitational force pulling it down, and the tension from the string pulling it up. For the block on the ramp, we have gravity, which we can split into components that are perpendicular and parallel to the surface it sits on, which means we also have a normal force, and then the tension from the string. Now let's fill in some values. For the hanging block, the gravitational force will be 12.7 newtons. For the block on the ramp, the gravitational force will be 34.3 newtons. But to get the relevant components, we have to do some trig. We could construct another triangle and use this angle here, but sometimes it's just easier to memorize that whatever the angle of the incline on the ramp, we take that to be theta, and mg sine theta gives us the parallel component, while mg cosine theta gives us the perpendicular component. 34.3 times the sine of 50 gives us 26.3 newtons, and we don't care about the perpendicular component, as that and the normal force will just cancel each other out. So we have a 26.3 newton force pulling block A down the ramp. That means this is also the tension pulling block B up. And as we said, 12.7 newtons is the force pulling block B down, and therefore also the tension pulling block A up the ramp. 26.3 minus 12.7 equals 13.6 newtons pointing in this direction. So that's the net force that will cause block A to slide down the ramp, thus pulling block B upwards. And that's what will happen. Remember, math doesn't lie. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.